In this class, we will discuss evaluation of herbal drugs. We will cover introduction, herbal formulations, method of drug evaluation, herbal drug formulations, evaluation of formulations, learning objectives. Crude drug. Naturally occurring unprocessed drug derived from plant, animal or microorganism intended for human or veterinary uses like medicine, nutritional supplements, dietary fibers, ingredients or cosmetics. These are mainly fragmented or broken plants, cut parts of plants, fungi or algae, lichen in an unprocessed state, usually in dried form, but sometimes fresh. Certain exudate that are not subjected to specified treatment are also considered as herbal drug. They are precisely defined by botanical scientific name according to binomial system, genus, species, variety, and author. The binomial nomenclature system is given by Carolus Linnaeus. This depends on genus and species. For example, neem leaf, dried leaf of Azadirachta indica, herbal formulations. These are usually obtained by subjecting the herbal drugs to treatments such as extraction, distillation, expression, fractionation, purification, concentration of fermentation. Herbal drug preparations includes extracts, essential oils, extract juices, processed exudates, and few herbals drug that are subjected to size reduction, for example, herbal teas or powder for encapsulation. Herbal drug formulation like tablet, capsule, aerosols, etc. are obtained from herbal drug preparations, for example, triphala tablet. Evaluation of herbal drugs involve confirmation of its identity and determination of its quality and purity and detection of nature of adulteration. The methods involved for evaluation of herbal drugs: organoleptic evaluation, microscopic evaluation, physical evaluation, chemical evaluation, analytical and biological evaluation. Organoleptic and microscopical evaluation has been already discussed in part 1. Now we are going to discuss physical evaluation. One more bright stone parameters, physical evaluation in the category of evaluation of herbal drug. In the physical evaluation, we will identify the different parameters, identification, test for foreign matters, loss on drying, moisture content, residue on ignition, determination of solvent extractive value. Extractive value, we will consider both water and alcohol soluble extractive, heavy metals, pesticide, residue test, microbial contamination, total alpha toxins and orcha toxins, assay bitterness value, swelling index. In physical evaluation, we have already discussed identification, test for foreign matters, loss on drying, moisture content, residue on index, which is already discussed in part 1. Now we are going to discuss physical evaluation and alcohol soluble extractive value. For determination of this, we have two methods, method 1 and method 2. First, we will discuss method 1. It is an important evaluation parameter. The method is take 5 gram of air dried powder drug, macerate it with 100 ml of water / or alcohol for 24 hours, shake it for 6 hours and allow it to stand for 18 hours. Then filter it, evaporate till 25 ml of filtrate to dryness. In a tiered flat bottom shallow dish, dry at 105 degrees Celsius and wait. Calculate percentage of water soluble extractive with reference to air dried drug. The second method is only for water soluble extractive. Take 5 gram of air dried drug in 50 ml of water and heated at 80 degrees Celsius in stoppered flask. Shake well and allow it to cool for 10 minutes and cool. Then add 2 gram of kijal gur and filter. Then transfer 5 ml of filtrate to tiered evaporating dish. Evaporate solvent on water bath. Continue drying for 30 minutes. Then finally dry in steam oven for 2 hours and wait residue. And then calculate the percentage of water soluble extractive with reference to air dried drug. The determination of alcohol soluble extractive with the help of method 1. Alcohol is an ideal solvent for extraction of various chemicals like tannins, alcohol, resin, etc. Ethyl alcohol, 95% volume by volume, was used for determination of alcohol soluble extractive value. Take 5 gram of powder drug was macerated with the 100 ml of ethanol closed flask for 24 hours and was occasionally shaken with the 6 hour with period and was allowed to stand for 18 hours. After filtration, the 25 ml of filtrate evaporated to dryness in a tiered flat bottomed shallow dish. Dried at 105 degrees Celsius and weighted, the percentage of ethanol soluble extractive value was calculated with reference to air dried drug. Next parameter is heavy metals and pesticide residue test. The limit for heavy metals is specified in monographs in terms of ppm by weight of the substance, for example lead, mercury, arsenic. Pesticide residue test. Pesticides are chemicals derived from synthesis and natural sources which is effective in small concentration against pests. Alpha toxins, poisons, mutagens that are usually produced by fungi. We should apply the assay to check active ingredients as per monograph. We also check the microbial contamination. This test is performed in order to control viable microorganism in drug or product. The next is total viable count. Total viable count can be calculated the total plate count method, membrane filtration method, serial dilution method. Test for specific organism such as Salmonella, Pseudomonas. Test for yeast and mold, which occurs only in water soluble drugs. These all tests have to perform for the purity, accuracy and safety of the drug, because the contaminated drugs can be make the disease and spoil the drug and deteriorate the quality of the drug. The next parameter is the chemical evaluation. In the chemical evaluation, we use the instruments, use of various instruments for evaluation like colorimetry, fluorimetry, spectroscopy, etc. and also perform the chemical test on the extraction of drug. The chemical tests like acid value, iodine value, and ester value, etc. for identification of fixed oil and fat. Individual constituent chemical tests can be performed for identifying the particular drug. Microchemical tests can also be performed. Analytical evaluation. For the analytical evaluation, we have to separate the two separate techniques, which is known as chromatography techniques and spectrophotometric techniques. In chromatography techniques, these are involved TLC, means thin layer chromatography, or upper version of TLC is high performance thin layer chromatography, HPLC, high performance liquid chromatography, gas liquid chromatography, gel permeation, affinity chromatography. In the field of spectrophotometric analysis, the methods are involved UV, ultraviolet spectroscopy, IR, infrared spectroscopy, NMR, RIA, and MS. These are helpful in identification of chemicals involved or in the drug. For the evaluation of the drug, these chemical parameters work as the marker and for the quality of the drug and decide the dosage from efficacy. The next parameter is biological evaluation. In the biological evaluation of the drug can be performed with the help of animal models or in vitro models. The evaluation of hypoglycemic, anti-inflammatory, anti-fertility, anti-ulcer activity in animal like male or female albino rats, rabbit, mice, etc. to estimate the potency of drug and to confirm the therapeutic activity of drug. The activity of drug depends on viability of the drug and quality of the drug, which will consider by the evaluation of the different parameters and help of different methods which are already discussed. Now we are going to discuss herbal drug formulations. These herbal drug formulations, first one, tablet, capsules, oral solution, suspensions, and emulsion, powders and granules for oral suspension or solution, meter dose, inhalers, and nasal aerosols, nasal spray solutions and suspension, topical, ophthalmic, and ear preparations, suppositories, small volume parenterals, large volume parenterals, transdermal patches. In the discussion of tablets is solid dosage form of pharmaceuticals. It is used orally. A solid unit dosage form, the tablet may be defined as the solid unit dosage form for the medicament or medicament with suitable excipient and prepared either by molding or compression. In Ayurvedic dosage form, it's known as bati. Capsules are also solid dosage forms which have the cell, the body, and cap. It's divided into two groups, soft gelatin capsules and hard gelatin capsules. The drug is enclosed in a hard or soft soluble containers, which are normally prepared by gelatin. These are mainly discussed formulations for preparation. These preparations are orally used or topically used. The small volume parenterals and large volume parenterals are intravenously used and other uses also. Suppositories are belong to the rectal use and vaginal use also. The transdermal patches is available in the market nowadays. In the evaluation of formulation, first one, hard gelatin capsules and tablet evaluation. These are coated and uncoated tablets. Dissolution and disintegration parameters involve and hardness, friability, uniformity of content and mass, water content, microbial limits. These are parameters can be identified during the evaluation of tablets. Weight variation and friability test can be determined for the its stability during the transportation. Hardness of capsule or tablets, it can be alter the formation and viability of a drug. Due to the very hard tablets, it take hard time or more time in disintegrates and dissolution also. In oral liquid evaluation, we will discuss uniformity of content. These parameters are important. First one, pH, microbial limits, antimicrobial preservatives contain, antioxidant preservative contains, extractable from containers, closure system, alcohol content. These all parameters are very valuable for evaluation for the efficacy, stability, and durability of the drug. Doses form. We should also cover these parameters for evaluation of drug. The parameters are particle size distribution, redispersibility for suspensions, doses form, viscosity for suspension and viscous solution, specific gravity for suspension, viscous solution, specific gravity can also determine water contained for powder reconstitution drug, doses form. The learning objective of this lecture is various methods of evaluation of herbal crude drug as well as formulation have been studied. It is an important parameter for the quality and efficacy of a formulation. Thank you.